This video is made for educational purpose only. All information is provided in good faith, however we make no representation or warranty of any kind. A self-research should be done before. If necessary, consulting doctor would be recommended.
Welcome to Baby Need. This YouTube channel answers all your parenting needs. We help you in directing your way through parenthood with baby care tips. It can be do's and don'ts while pregnancy, prenatal development through our wide variety of videos, month-by-month development to health and nutrition. What is co-sleeping and why is it important to stop? Co-sleeping is a practice in which parents and their children sleep in the same bed. It has been a popular habit for many years now, but recent studies have shown that it can be harmful to the child's health. Co-sleeping is a practice in which parents and their children sleep in the same bed. It has been a popular habit for many years now, but recent studies show that it can be harmful to the child's health. How do you know if your child is ready for separate sleeping arrangements? The American Academy of Pediatrics recommends that children sleep in the same room as their parents for at least the first 6 months, but ideally for the first year. In general, a child is ready to sleep in their own room when they are able to fall asleep without parental help. Stay asleep without parental help. Wake up from a night's sleep without parental assistance and not be upset or scared. Not need to bring their favorite stuffed animal or other item from home into their bed with them. You have a choice, how to stop co-sleeping. The idea of co-sleeping has been around for a long time. It is believed that sleeping in the same bed with your baby will reduce the risk of SIDS, sudden infant death syndrome. But recent studies have shown that this is not true. In fact, it may increase the risk of SIDS, suffocation, and accidental death. There are many benefits to co-sleeping with your baby. For example, it can help you bond with your child and make nighttime feedings easier. But there are also many risks to co-sleeping as well. Suffocation, accidental death, and SIDS. So what should you do? Ultimately, it's up to you to decide when you want to stop co-sleeping with your baby. You should weigh all the pros and cons. 5 ways you can start sleeping better and stop co-sleeping. 1. Make the bedtime routine more exciting. 2. Keep your child occupied before bedtime. 3. Create a comfortable and safe environment for sleep time. 4. Teach your child to fall asleep on their own, without you being there to help them fall asleep or stay asleep every night. 5. If you are breastfeeding, stop doing so before bedtime to avoid feeding throughout the night. Sleeping without your kid, pros and cons. Sleeping without your child can be a difficult decision. There are many reasons why parents choose to sleep without their children, but it is important to weigh the pros and cons of this decision. The pros for sleeping without your child include: parents have more time to themselves. Parents can have more time with their partner or spouse. Parents can get a better night's sleep. Parents are less likely to roll over on the child while they sleep. A parent may not be able to hear the baby cry in distress if they are asleep. The cons of sleeping without your child include: the parent will not know when the baby wakes up at night, which could lead to a late-night feeding session or early morning wake-up call. When does a child need to sleep alone? The conclusion of this video is that children under the age of 1 should not sleep alone. There are many reasons why a child should not sleep alone. The first and most important reason is that they need to be close to their caregiver in order to fall asleep. They also need to feel safe and secure when they are sleeping. If they are sleeping with their caregiver, then they will feel safer because the caregiver will wake up if the child needs help or falls asleep while breastfeeding. The second reason is that if a child sleeps with their caregiver, it can help them sleep better because it helps them learn how to regulate their own body's natural cycles. The third reason is that children who share a bed with their parents have lower rates of sudden infant death syndrome, SIDS. Please like, share, subscribe to our channel for more videos and also comment your questions in the comment box below.